me. You're the lady who eggs and light and tonight. Take my hand off to Never Never Land. Okay, there is so much going on that happened at ComicCon this past weekend that I want to share a few of the panels with you for here in the midweek. And so I'm going to share the Marvel panel that shared from with the cast of Ant-Man and also with the Avengers Age of Ultron cast. So I'm going to go ahead and share those with you. We'll have a further discussion about this on our next regular show coming up this next weekend. But until then, enjoy this audio I've dug up, uncovered or dug up, whatever you choose.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kevin Feige!
Hello, how are you?
Welcome, Mr. Feige, how are you?
I'm very, very good.
Good.
Hello? Now,
How are you feeling?
I snuck out there to watch that piece with you guys because it still blows my mind that Guardians of the Galaxy that comes out next Friday.
I saw it, by the way. I went to the, you let me come to the premiere, and it is honestly, it is beyond any, and I swear I'm not just saying that because you're here, but James Gunn has managed to make a visually stunning film that is hilarious and action. It's absolutely, go see it.
But it is our 10th Marvel Studios movie. The tenth movie that takes place in our cinematic universe, and I can't believe and I can't wait for you guys to see it, because it always starts in this room. It always starts with you guys in this room. From Jon Favreau walking out there in 2000, whatever, 6 or 7, it's been amazing. And we put that piece together just for this room. And it's very, very cool. And what's exciting, particularly this year, is we had a movie called Captain America: The Winter Soldier. Guardians comes out this Friday, and I love the notion that you guys are just as excited for a part two or a part three, something that you've already seen before, the next adventure, but you're just as excited for something fresh and something new with Guardians. And what we're going to talk about today is 2015, where we're doing a very similar thing. We have a movie called Avengers Age of Ultron that comes out.
I've heard of it.
And then we have something new. Ant-Man is finally coming out. And you want to meet some people involved in Ant-Man? All right. The director of Ant-Man, Peyton Reed. This is the first time visiting Comic-Con for both of the Ant-Men I'm about to introduce you to, Paul Rudd and Michael Douglas. Hank Pym, Michael Douglas, here he is. First time. The villain of our piece, his name is Darren Cross. We also call him the Yellow Jacket in the film, Corey Stahl. And there have been some rumors recently about who's playing this part in the film, but now finally confirming, no more rumors, playing the daughter of Hank Pym, Hope Van Dyne, Evangeline Lilly. Excellent.
Your 2015 Ant-Man cast. Let's start with Peyton Reed, who, if you had any question as to whether or not Peyton might be the right guy for this job, what number of Comic-Con, San Diego International Comic-Con, is this for you, Peyton Reed?
This is my 20th anniversary visit to Comic-Con. 1994 was the first summer I went to Comic-Con. It was the year Jack Kirby passed away, and I have been every year since then, I think minus a couple of years when I was shooting.
And what was the punk band in high school that you were in?
Oh, yes.
I was a drummer for a time in the 80s in a punk band called Johnny Quest. And thank you. And in addition to being the drummer, I was in charge of drawing the flyers for the shows. And we did a show, I think, in 1988. And I drew a sort of a ripoff of Avengers number one, where all the band members were members of the Avengers. And of course, Ant-Man was an original Avenger. And I drew myself as Ant-Man. And I would love to...
Did they bring that? Yeah, there it is. Yeah.
There he is.
That's that sweet new Johnny Quest LP that all the kids are digging.
Yeah, there's going to be a big reunion.
Is that you down on the drums?
That's me flying on the twin snare drum thing, the substitute for the flying carpenter ant.
Peyton did not tell us this when we met him for the job. It wasn't until long into he's already been working on the film that he brought this out. And he didn't tell Paul. I just told Paul about it and Michael about it yesterday. So yeah. His fandom runs deep.
I'll get you a cassette of the music, Paul.
I have a Walkman right here. I could totally play it. I could totally play it on the Walkman. Paul Rudd, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Wow.
You've never been to Comic-Con, you've never sat up on this stage before?
This is my first time here.
And here at Con, they call that a Comic-Con virgin.
Yeah.
I'm a Comic-Con virgin. What?
Don't shout pop the cherry at him. That's disgusting.
I didn't even
It's a human being. How dare you?
It. That's what it was.
Yeah.
I'm popping my Comic-Con cherry.
This is it.
And it is as advertised. This is unbelievable.
If you're going to do it with 7,000 people.
Hey, right? Yeah.
So how does it feel to basically to come into the Marvel Universe as, you know, what will probably be another, like, tentpole? Like, you're going to be this guy for a while. Like, what does that feel like?
It's a mind bender. It's so exciting. I'm so honored to be a part of it. It's really thrilling. And it's kind of tough to wrap my brain around. I mean, I've been doing this as a job for a while, but this is a whole other thing. And I'm excited by the challenges. I'm thrilled to be working with such great people. And looking forward to seeing how it all is.
Excellent. Mr. Michael Douglas. Yes, I never thought I would say this to you, but we're also popping your cherry as well. It's very awkward.
I popped enough cherries, so... Might as well.
All right. Don't think I don't want to just talk about that for the next hour.
Oh, come on.
What is the experience been like for you to come in as Hank Pym? And what do you see? What do you envision for the character?
Well, you know, I've always vicariously looked at Marvel films from afar with tremendous envy. My entire career has been making up of doing kind of contemporary movies without any special effects or anything. To have the joy and the love of all these fantastic tools that so well done. And the Ant-Man story is a wonderful story. And so to be surrounded with Peyton, Paul, Evangeline, Corey, I'm just looking forward to a real trip. This is sort of based upon a comic and started out in 1962. Stan Lee wrote it about a doctor, Henry Pym, who was an endocrinologist, also physicist, a metallurgist, and basically developed a serum to make a person reduce themselves to the size of an ant, but with the strength of a human being, and then went beyond that, more importantly, to learn how to communicate with ants, because ants are armies.
Mm-hmm.
And so this is basically the story of a heist of his partner. Corey plays that role, which has taken the company in a different evil direction. And I have found a mentor in Paul to take over my position as Ant-Man. The only trouble is that Paul is in such great shape, such incredible shape, that the physique, the Ant-Man bodysuit just didn't, we had to soften it up, you know what I mean, just to make him look good.
Startling.
We're the first Marvel movie that's spending a lot of money on CGI to remove muscles from our hero.
Smooth those out. You know what?
Most of this, where most of the budget is going.
Let's just bring it down to a 4-pack, Paul. Evangeline Lilly, who has been all over Hall H today. You've just been back and forth.
I was looking out in the crowd and I was like, hang on a minute. I saw these people this morning.
Oh, yeah. They stay here all day. They don't leave.
I recognize you guys. Gray wig. You're the comment girl in the front. She always has something to say. The pop the cherry girl.
Yeah. You don't want to be referred to as that. Tell us about Hope Van Dyne and what your experience has been like so far.
My experience so far has been just evading the press. That's been generally been my experience on Ant-Man. I've been at Comic-Con for 2 days now answering questions about Ant-Man, but officially saying I'm not in Ant-Man. Mm-hmm. So I'm very glad to announce it. I'm super happy to be here. I'm obviously playing Hank Pym's daughter, Hope Pym, say that 5 times fast. And I can't tell you anything else about her because I don't know. I don't have a script.
Not yet. Now you're just at the point where you can say that you're in it.
I'm like, hi, I'm in it. I'm here. Glad to be here. Thanks, guys.
I mean, this has really been an incredible couple of years for you, just in terms of the scale of stuff that you're working on. So what is it? How do you sleep?
I don't do a lot of sleeping. Actually, in the last 6 months, I started learning meditative breathing practices, swear to God, just so I can get some sleep. I'm a mother. I'm producing my first children's book series and finishing up the Hobbit series and starting this one. So I'm having a great time. Con is kind of my world. I mean, everything, it seems like everything I've ever done on the screen, you guys are right in the fray. You're in the mix lost, right? So I started here in 2005, and I was in Hall H, and we were showing a television show that wasn't even on air yet, and this was still a packed auditorium. So much love to all of you. I love my people.
Corey Stahl, also here, who's playing a character by the name of Darren Cross. What can you tell us about Darren Cross, Corey?
I think that was about it. I was Hank Pym's mentee and a genius scientist as well. I've taken over the company, and some very judgmental people may think that that's in an evil direction, but I think I'm just taking it into the future.
What can you, Kev? Can you tell us anything about Darren Cross?
I think he did a marvelous job. He does, at a certain point, obtain some Pym particles, and begins to give Ant-Man a run for his money. And again, puts on a suit that is called the Yellow Jacket suit in the film, and causes havoc.
So Darren Cross actually will be Yellow Jacket in the film.
Hey.
Which is not previously announced. Now, is it? You have to keep all this stuff in the entire time. So Comic-Con for you must be like an incredible release where you can be open about everything.
Popping cherries release. This is a family event.
That's how families get made. That's how families get made.
Yes.
Some of them, a lot of them tonight. 7,000 families will get made tonight in a weird Comic-Con pyramid scheme. But you guys don't you don't have any Ant-Man footage to show yet, right? Because you haven't started filming yet.
Well, no, we start filming in 2 weeks. We start filming on the 18th, Monday, August 18th in Atlanta. Come on, don't come by. So we haven't started filming the movie yet, but we filmed a little something to show you guys today. Thanks to Peyton, thanks to Paul, thanks to Michael, and thanks to some of the visual effects tests we have in the works. Here's a quick look at Ant-Man.
Ladies and gentlemen, the cast of Ant-Man now actually has to go make the movie. Here they are. Peyton Reed, Paul Rudd.
Be seated. To happen. Welcome, Avengers.
Brian Tanner Jr., first of all, I'd please compliment you on your excellent taste in music and Michael Jackson song that you came out to. It was a phenomenal groove. So we'll just go down the line and talk to everyone. How do you feel? You've been Iron Man for a while, as you probably know, because you're you. How does it feel being here, Comic-Con, Iron Man, anything?
It just keeps getting better, and I'm so excited that we're all here. This is the longest bench of talent I've ever been a part of, and we got a real nice movie coming up for you guys next year.
I mean, in terms of all the films you've done, this is probably the first time that you're actually, I mean, you're genuinely part of this family of people now that's ongoing.
Yeah, and I become a little less significant every time, which is just fine. Because they're all so damn good. You're probably right.
Hey, Jeremy, how's it going?
What? Yeah, I'm wearing pants.
So, now that you've done this a couple of times, does this seem like old hat to you, or is it comfortable? Does it still seem exciting and new?
No, it's always thrilling, man. It's always like it's a Friday next week, and it's going to be just exciting next Friday. It's always a brand new, amazing thing. Glad to be here. Very honored.
Every day do you go to work, do you go, this is strange that I get paid to do this every day?
What I'm doing now?
No, not this. This is, you're not getting paid for this. I mean,
no, Jeremy was promised compensation. We're going to have to discuss this.
We're going to do a Kickstarter. We're going to kickstart Jeremy's panel. But I mean, just, you know, getting over with this group of people and essentially being a superhero for a job. I mean, was this what you envisioned when you're like, oh, I want to be an actor? Like, is this anywhere near what you thought?
No. It's but a wonderful blessing. Meeting this guy over here, he's the one that convinced me and washed my car in a thong and said that you got to be a hot guy.
Oh yeah, Michael Bay style. That's
nice.
He
did do that. Washed my car in a thong is amazing. I thought I'll Instagram that shit. But no, I mean, it's easy to want to join. Wasn't very hard convincing me to do it, and never envisioned it. But I'm glad to be a part of this amazing group of humans sitting at this table.
Yeah. Mark Ruffalo, we did the panel for when the Avengers was first announced. There really wasn't a whole lot of footage, and we were at New York Comic Con, and you were on the panel. And at the time, you're like, I don't really understand all this Comic Con stuff and what this is. And you did it, and since then, it completely blew up. Did this exceed your expectations?
Slightly, by a huge margin, and they don't treat me like this at home. That's for sure. It's pretty. It's that's really nice. Thank you.
Oh crap! Just shave, Mark.
No, don't get him excited! That's when it gets bad! You have to keep his pulse down! Do people shout Hulk things at you just out in public?
People don't even know who I am other than Hulk. I walk down the street and they're just like, "Yo, Hulk! Hulk! Hulk!"
You just go, "The name's Banner," and then just keep walking.
It's actually Banner.
Chris, hey, how's it going, man? You are in exceptionally good shape.
Yeah, I hang out with these guys.
Okay, oh, stop it. Guys, just stop it. Stop it! That arm is the size of my torso. What has Thor meant to you all this time?
I mean, as these guys said, this is, for me, the same thing, one of the best experiences I've had on a set, off a set, to work with this group of people and to bring this character to life and be part of this madness is just an honor. It's awesome.
Is there anything that you haven't done as Thor yet that you feel like, oh, I just really want to do this thing as Thor, I really want Thor to do this?
Turn him into a woman. I don't want to speak too early and jinx it, but I think it could be my Oscar. It's going to be a big transformation, but I'm willing to take it on.
You can do it.
Pause while everyone stops to picture you in a dress and then has a lot of feelings.
You'd be an ugly chick, man, I gotta tell you. Be ugly.
Nah, he's got that pretty girl hair. I think he'd be fine.
Weeks.
Kobe Smulders also moving down the mound.
Hi.
Woo. Hey.
Hi.
Maria Hill.
Hi.
What are you doing?
Just hanging out with a bunch of people up here.
We were talking about backstage. Yeah, we were just talking a little bit about stage. Like, what a whirlwind is it? They can basically swoop in and do this, and people scream and cheer, and then you leave. Do you get to enjoy the Comic-Con at all?
Yeah, not the, you know, going on the floor or anything, but it was my first time doing a signing with these guys, which was pretty incredible to get to meet people and sign pictures and kind of connect for a second, so.
Excellent. And did you I think we talked, you didn't expect, like, this would just keep going on and on for Maria, right?
No, I hoped. Yeah, but when Joss is the one who kind of brought me into this world, and I'm sorry he can't be here, I'm sure he wishes he could be, but he kind of brought me into this world, and it's just been fun, just keep going on the films and on the TV, and I'm so grateful, so.
Excellent. Sam Jackson, does it feel?
Yeah.
I can't hear the question. Please.
Does it feel good to put the eye patch back on? Because I feel like last time we talked about it, you're like, I bump into stuff a lot because of my depth perception with the eye patch on.
I was smart enough to figure it out. I stop running into things and I just keep my head to the right. And all works out fine. I've got that down pat.
Good.
I have that down pat now, Kevin. You can cancel the insurance. Everybody's like, huh?
So how do you feel? Like, how do you think Nick Fury would react to this type of reception?
You know, Comic-Con is phenomenal. It's totally amazing. It's like every year, I've been coming here since like episode one, Star Wars. So it seems like every year I come here and it validates the fact that I belong and I get all this energy and love from everybody. It makes me feel like going out and making movies for the rest of the year. We make movies because we want to entertain you guys, and I make movies because I want to see myself in them. It's the perfect combination for me, all this love, and it just energizes me, and I can't wait to come back next year with the next movie.
Excellent. Now let's go over to Chris Evans, who's...
going down the line thing. This is intimidating.
It's very assembly line. The whole time you're like, what am I going to say? What's my answer going to be? What's going to be? I heard a story that I wanted to confirm from you, and I don't know if it's true, but I heard that when you and Hemsworth were sort of working together, that you guys were like comparing like muscle ribbage, and you're like, but how do you get this little piece right here?
What? There's no comparison. I mean, come on. It's very difficult to stand next to him. He is Thor. It's not just a costume. He is an enormous. It's difficult to try and keep up.
How do you keep up? Like how long is your workout year?
Magic, CGI. I'm a stuntman and you know.
Congratulations on that success of Winter Soldier.
Yes.
Do you feel like at this point that Steve, that Cap is, like, fitting? Does he feel more acclimated to this world yet, or does he still feel a little isolated?
Well, no, I think he's getting there. I think we're past, you know, he's not just, you know, amazed at cell phones and the internet. I mean, I think he's up to speed, but I think he's still looking for a place to belong. You know, he's for so long been a servant. You know, he fits in as a soldier. You know, he's used to kind of this chain of command, and since S.H.I.E.L.D. kind of fell apart in the last movie, it's more about this group of people depending upon each other without kind of a clear leader, and I think he's searching for, you know, home.
Yeah. I'd like to welcome Aaron Taylor Johnson. Quick sell up. But we just get a peek of a little bit. How's it felt coming into this established world with all these people who've been working together as kind of as the new guy?
Yeah, you know, pretty overwhelming. And surreal, and you know, I was flattered to, you know, that Joss and the Marvel guys approached me for this, and you know, don't hesitate. You know, it's huge. You know, it's incredible to be a part of this gang, and great actors, and
was there anything about doing a superhero film that you never envisioned before? Like, what's different about it than other stuff that you've done?
What, the Avengers?
Yeah.
I think, you know, I mean. You know, it's just the characters, you have such a dynamic between, you know, the group, and I think, you know, what Joss did for the first one was, which seemed like a mission completely impossible to do, but everyone had their moment and stood out, and, you know, what's beautiful is you get these kind of characters in the same room and they bounce off each other, you know, there's banter and humour, and it's... And he has that tone where it can be have a journey and be emotional and sad at moments and you know, lighthearted and action packed. You know, it's, you know, I thoroughly enjoy all the Marvel movies and was so excited to be a part of this one.
Excellent.
Thank you for having me.
All right. I'll probably dig up a little bit more audio and share it sometime later this week, if I can. I'm going to burn up as much of the memory as I'm allowed to use on Libsyn, basically, for the month. And as long as I have enough room, I'll try to squeeze in a little bit more. I found some a panel from the Agent Peggy Carter series, a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Nickelodeon panel. You know, anything I can squeeze in there that I can share with you, I will gladly share with you. Hopefully you subscribed via iTunes and Stitcher, so you're hearing this. If you haven't subscribed via iTunes and Stitcher, well, I guess you're not going to get this because I don't plan on necessarily posting it to the website. So this is just between you and me on iTunes and Stitcher. So hope you've enjoyed it and stay tuned for more.